When it comes to the study of engineering, computer science and technology, there is no better time than right now. Since 2020, the Australian National University has been going through a period of change and adjustment responding to the COVID-19 pandemic. We're continuing to learn and innovate, taking the very best of off-campus, remote and hybrid experiences and weaving them into a rich tapestry of student learning experiences. In this video, you'll see we remain an active campus and get a little taste of what it's like to study here at ANU in the College of Engineering and Computer Science.
So it is the 20th of July and I am standing in the seminar room in the Hannah Neumann building.
We're at a Capstone event. Capstone is basically a course run by ANU CECS, which is the College of Engineering and Computer Science.
Capstone is like the big systems engineering project you do in your final year or close to your final year. You do it with a team, you have a real world client, and you're solving a real world problem.
Working with a company, working with the brief that they provided to us, and then developing a project and delivering on that.
It's not just about the course mark, it's about how well you fulfill the client's expectations.
So we check in each week with a tutor, and then at the very end we develop the projects.
We present all our projects to an interested audience, mostly clients and other people from industry.
Being in the, not even the wake of COVID, but still having it going on around us, I think Canberra's in a pretty good position at the moment that we're able to have events like this.
All right, so the last time I was in this room was at the end of semester two, 2019. I do live coding. I've normally got my laptop right here. I'm coding and the code's up on the screen and I'm asking the class how to work through a problem with me, and we work through the problem together and we solve it. We often run into bugs. So then wind the clock forward, semester two, 2020, and we can't come to this room and I've got to deliver the lectures from my little office at home. However, I soon found that it was actually overwhelming. It's cognitively demanding to do live coding in any class, but it's even more demanding when you're doing that and monitoring your live stream, and more demanding still if you're monitoring the live stream, doing the live coding, and watching the chat stream for questions. And so a very enthusiastic and capable tutor put their hand up and said they were willing to moderate the student questions, and that was great.
I was thinking this course is a first year course and a lot of students just came straight to their uni life, I mean, without even being here. So it would be great if we could bring the interaction back, even that's online.
So I'm preparing right now for the coming semester, and what I wanted to do, and we'll see how it goes, is to try and get the best of both worlds. So I'm back in this room, and my plan is to deliver it just like I did before, with a live streaming happening at the same time. And I've managed to get Leo to come into the classroom to monitor the chat from those who are not in the room.
I'm just so excited to be here again, because that marks a new beginning to try something like hybrid and new.
Hey Leo, can you just check the audio on the stream?
Steve, all good.
All good? All right, folks, I think I'll make a start. Welcome back to Comp 1110. It's great to see you here in person. It's wonderful to be in a lecture theatre with real people in it. And for those of you who are on the live stream, thank you for joining us.
Doubles are a way of representing floating point numbers. So we just did int, we did boolean, and
we're about to do double, okay? Double is a floating point number, okay?
Hi, Steve. Yep. I've got a question from Adam. He asked, do all Java programs need to be main methods inside classes?
Right, great question. The question is, do all Java programs need to have a main method inside the class? And the answer is, if it's a program, it does.
One thing that the team at the School of Cybernetics is really thinking about is how with any learning experience we build, do we engage heads, hands and hearts? So even if it's a virtual experience, how are we engaging you not only in terms of the content we are developing and delivering, but also how are we engaging your heart? What kind of story are we telling? Why is this interesting and why does it matter? How are we helping you engage with each other?
A lot of people underestimate how important social skills are in computer science. In fact, there's stereotypes that say social skills are not part of computer science. That's absolutely false. If you go to any major company and look at who's doing the recruiting there, they'll be looking for your social skills.
For me, it was really interesting to transition from an undergraduate university that was really focused on engineering. Engineering was the core of our being, to a university here where engineering isn't the biggest thing, but that kind of works sometimes. It means that they look at engineering a little bit differently and they look at engineering's place within the world, trying to use engineering to solve social problems, to have a positive social impact, and really placing engineering positively within the context of the actual human world.
We are the first school of cybernetics in Australia. We are the first to be thinking about this iteration of cybernetics around the world. And this is the moment. We saw cybernetics, the original cybernetics agenda, grow out of a moment of global disruption, global rupture. The Second World War, people stepped away from that and said, we need to make sure that the world in future looks different to the past. We can understand that people and technology and environment come together to create all sorts of global events. And some of those are not what we want to see in future. And I think we're at another one of those moments now, right? There's global rupture. There is an opportunity for great change. And there's also a real impetus for great change because we can see the results of these people and environment and technology coming together and may not be where we want to be.
Computer science has become so important to so many things. I think most people begin to appreciate just how important it is. But ANU is really a great place to do that because it has strength in so many areas. And computer science finds its way into so many different areas. So I know people at ANU who are world leaders, for example, in medicine, who are doing computational medicine, trying to find cures to cancer and things like that using very advanced computing techniques. Astronomy is another great example. Economics. People are even using it in the fine arts. So there's a whole, there's almost no limit to how many different areas can benefit from computer science. So it's a fantastic anchor to nearly any discipline area study at this university. And the richness of what goes on this campus really adds to it because we've got world-leading experts in each of these areas.
We hope we're leading the world. We hope this is just the beginning and that this is a program that if we get it right, you will start to see in other parts of the world in the not too distant future. The ongoing mission to build a new branch of engineering, to take AI-enabled systems and the systems that we live in today that have technology, ecology and people at their heart, how do we take them safely, sustainably and responsibly to scale to build a future we all want to live in?
Within engineering, that's getting the people who do electronics to talk to the people who do materials design and the people who do mechanics. But sometimes that also means getting the people who work on the physical electronic device to talk to the people over in humanities or policy to make sure that it's actually implemented. Because there's no point in designing an amazing solution to a problem if no one's ever actually going to use it. So we really focus on learning enough to be able to jump into any project and understand who else you need to go talk to, where you can get that other bit of knowledge you need for that specific project and how you can really make it work.
This is your final height, the pinnacle of your journey at ANU and CECS. But I hope that it's the start of a return journey for the students among us and for our industry partners and peak bodies that continues over time. Because we're a launch pad for you. We want you to launch, soar, and come back.